What I love about you two is your love for stories.
Stories have marked you, and right now, you're going to start a new one together. And this marriage will be a story, and so the question that I'm going to ask you and charge you with is, what will mark your story?
Because she so faithfully trusts God, and I know I can always count on her for honest and meaningful conversations.
And she just complimented Dave in all the best ways: competitive, kind, gracious, humble. And you guys just work so well together, and not just like in a relationship, but infecting other people's relationships as well. And I think that's the big part. You guys are very great at not just being two, but two for the world.
David has been my best friend, and he has been a rock in my life.
David, I'm so thankful for your strong faith, your fierce love for Claire, and the laughter you bring to her life. I am really looking forward to seeing the beautiful life you two create together. And when trials come, I'm confident that you will withstand them together because your foundation is strong and resting on God.
Having to hold to, we're both growing. Cherish your heart in the light and the dark. Every chapter, every verse, darling, I do.
Darling, I do.
I want all of you. I want all of you. I want.
Oh my goodness, Claire, you're so beautiful.
Now, you've asked this verse for us to expound on your wedding, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. What I want to charge you with is that for that text to mark your story. You're about to declare in front of your friends and family who you promise to be when the feelings aren't present. See, the idea of this marriage is not just this party tonight, but a life together that will be a story where there are moments of beauty and there are moments of sorrow. There are moments of rest and there are moments of challenge. And what your wedding vows are promises that you can bank on when, if there's ever insecurity about, hey, how does my husband still love me because of this thing that happened? Does my wife still care for me? The answer you can say is yes. And why? Because of what you're about to say and bank on from one another.
I, David, take you, Claire, to be my wedded wife.
I, Claire, take you, David, to be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
And I do promise.
Before God and these witnesses.
be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
As long as we both shall live.
And may God deal with me.
Ever so severely.
If anything but death separates me from you.
Now by the virtue of the authority vested in me as an ordained minister of the Church of Jesus Christ, and by the law of the state of Washington, I now pronounce that you, David and Claire, are husband and wife.
For as long as you both are here on this earth.
Without hesitation, Tracy and I are absolutely thrilled that you're now man and wife.
And I'm so grateful for both of you. I'm so grateful for the life that you will have, and just I will continue to pray every single day over your lives.
Let's raise our glass to the two of you now. You're a great couple full of super and wow. We pray that the spark never is gone. And from here to forever, you will always fight on.